Good morning, everybody, on this New Year's Day. Jennifer Hoff coming to you from the scene of a police shooting here in Minneapolis at 36th and Cedar. We wanted to give you a quick update the morning of New Year's Day here, which is now 2 days after the shooting happened here at the gas station behind me. Here's what we know so far. The Hennepin County Medical Examiner has confirmed the identity of the man who was killed as 23-year-old Dalal Id. This was a shooting, an exchange of gunfire that happened between Minneapolis police and Dalal Id on Wednesday evening. The Minneapolis police chief described Id as a felony suspect who was under a probable cause weapons investigation. And they originally pulled him over here in the parking lot of the Holiday gas station. Body cam video was then eventually released the next afternoon, which is frankly the quickest Minneapolis police have ever released that type of information. And in the video, you can see that exchange of gunfire. Minneapolis police say it was Dalal Id who fired first at them. And you can see the smoke coming from the gun and his window cracking as he fired from his white vehicle, and then other officers opened fire. We are still working to learn how many officers may have fired their weapons and exactly who they are. The vehicle is then seen trying to drive away before being blocked by other squad cars, and you can hear officers yelling in the video.
Hands up!
In the nights that followed, we know that about 100 people gathered here at the scene to demand answers, including Dalal Id's father. And then last night, there was also a vigil held in his honor at the gas station. Now, as part of a 2019 sentence, Dalal Id was not allowed to be carrying any weapons or ammunition. Certainly, this is an area that is healing. It is still in a lot of pain following years of social injustice, but also since the shooting of George Floyd that happened back in May. Certainly a story we will continue to follow here in the days and weeks ahead. You can watch that body cam video as well as read statements from both the Minneapolis police chief, the Minneapolis mayor, as well as spokespeople from CARE Minnesota.